Welcome to TalkFCB and welcome back here to the channel, guys. Hope that you're all doing well. Hope that you're all staying safe right around the world. And in today's video, it is a Barcelona news roundup. I'm going to be bringing you the latest from the world of FCB because, to be honest, there's plenty to discuss right now. And it's not just transfers. Of course, we're going to be talking about Lautaro. We're going to be talking about Aubameyang, Ben Yedder. There's so much coming up in today's video, but we're also going to be talking about a few injury updates. We're going to be talking about the future of Samuel Umtiti. I'm trying to keep you guys updated on every possible base. So without further ado, let's get to it. And I do want to start here by talking about one of our youngest talents right now. And he's not actually at the club yet, because I want to start here by talking about Pedri. The 17-year-old is currently playing his football at Las Palmas. But come July the 1st, he will officially there sign for FC Barcelona. And it's interesting this morning that Sport have come out and they basically said that when Pedri signed for the club, he's very, very highly rated. He's really, really talented. When he signs there, he will stay with the first team for pre-season training. Whenever pre-season training exactly will be, we don't really know if it's definitely going to be the summer or beyond, but whenever that happens, Pedri will get his chance there just to show what he's got in that first team, and then perhaps we can evaluate exactly what to do with him. Like I say, he's very highly rated. It's not ruled out, according to Sport there, that he stays with the first team. That would be very, very interesting to see. Barcelona B, of course, is an option, and also they're going out on loan. But just to give you an update there, because many of you I know very excited about Pedri, and I think from the early signs, we've every right to be. And I also just want to give you guys an update here on the recoveries of Ousmane Dembele and Luis Suarez, with Suarez hoping to return towards the end of April, and Ousmane Dembele there aiming perhaps for the start of August to make their return from their long-term injury problems. And I just want to make it absolutely clear right now that even though the club, of course, has suspended every single first-team activity within the club, there's no training, there's no staff on site, there's nothing like that. Everybody in Spain right now is trying to stay at home, and rightly so. But I just want to clarify, that doesn't mean there that Dembele, that Suarez, that they're not doing any sort of training to keep that recovery going. According here to reports in the local media this morning, they're working on their recovery. They've been given, apparently, a specific gym plan that basically they've got to stick to while they're at home. They can follow it. They're also regularly video calling there with Barcelona's physiotherapist. So clearly, they're still keeping in contact with the club. They're still working hard on that recovery, and everything there is staying nicely on track. So don't think here that just because they're not training, just because Barcelona are not technically in work, they're not still going with their fitness. And to be honest, not just Dembele, not just Suarez, but I'd expect all the players there, certainly at home, to be keeping up with their fitness, to be keeping as match sharp as you possibly can, because also we don't know when football is going to return. So keep that fitness there, keep on going, and of course, hoping we'll be back soon. And speaking here about that physical fitness, we do now move on to Samuel Umtiti. Just before, of course, the enforced break from La Liga, he was struggling there with some problems that had forced him to miss a number of training sessions. Now, Sport have come out this morning and actually issued a report there following up on those particular issues, because they say that Samuel Umtiti's physical state in general right now is still questionable. They're still not really sure exactly how Umtiti is recovering game by game. They actually go on to say there that Umtiti really struggles to play two or more games in succession without then suffering a bit of a problem afterwards, a bit of discomfort, something there of a physical problem, which is something there that I think all of us have been fearing about Samuel Umtiti ever since back last season when he had that knee trouble, when he had that problem, he didn't undergo surgery. And ever since then, every single game that he plays, even if he plays well, you're thinking, yeah, but is he going to be okay after this game? Is he going to be able to play the next game? And Sport actually go here even further, saying that this summer, Barcelona will put Umtiti on the transfer market, and they're going to try and aim to sell him there to the Premier League, with the likes of Arsenal, Manchester United, certainly here in the media in the UK, very heavily linked recently with a move there to Samuel Umtiti over the past few days. And it is going to be interesting come the summer now, what's going to happen with Umtiti? Where does his future lie? And with Umtiti there possibly departing, it all does seem to revolve around Barcelona's aim this summer to rebuild that defence, which MD here have picked up on this morning, hinting with their headline, casting of the centre-backs. They're talking about potential new defenders who could be joining the club, with Lazio's Luis Felipe once again being linked to Barcelona this summer on the cover of their Wednesday's edition. And the centre-backs agent openly admitted over the past few days that going to Barcelona would be an honour. He said, it's an absolute privilege to be linked with Barcelona for my client, but he says that right now, no approach has been made and the player is fully focused on trying to win Serie A with Lazio when the season continues. But this is a name quite clearly, that not just one report now, not just a random article, this is a player now that's starting to be linked more and more with Barcelona, and certainly there when football continues, it'll be very well worth having a look at Luis Felipe, who also happens to have an Italian passport, so he wouldn't be there a non-EU player. He's worth having a look at. But now we do move on to those forwards that have been linked with Barcelona. Many, many reports over the past few days. Pretty much every single day, there's a new report there linking Barcelona with a move for Lautaro Martinez. And it really does look now more and more likely with every passing day. That is the route that Barcelona are going to go down this summer. And it also looks quite likely that given the current Barcelona squad, given the players that we have and are trying to offload, one or more player could be included in a potential swap deal with into this summer, a cash plus player deal to sign Lautaro. Now, right now, Arturo Vidal is a player who's been linked with Inter on a number of occasions. He's somebody who could certainly be used in a potential deal there for Lautaro Martinez. He's very, very close, of course, to joining Inter back in January. And of course, he still maintains a very, very close relationship with their coach, Antonio Conte. That could be a potential option. However, Arturo Vidal is not the only player who's been linked with a switch to Inter as part of that deal. With the Italian source there, Tutto Sport, claiming that Inter are big, big admirers of Arthur Melo, and they would request the Brazilian midfielder in any deal for Lautaro Martinez this summer. But for me, I don't see that happening. I don't see that happening, and I don't want that to happen. Number one, Tutto Sport are an extremely unreliable source in Italy, so I would take that there with a pinch of salt. Number two, I strongly believe that Barcelona very much count on Arthur. They want to see him play more often. They want to see him play more regularly. They know that when he's on the pitch, he can certainly be a big, big asset to our midfield. And number three, Arthur wants to succeed here. It's his dream to play here. He's loving every second of it. He wants to play more regularly, but he doesn't want to be leaving right now. Certainly not there joining into this summer. And just to show you there a bit of Tutto Sport's reliability, within a matter of hours after that original report, they're linking into to Arthur. They've now come out and said that actually, Ousmane Dembele could be going there as part of the Lautaro deal. And at this point, it just seems as though in the Italian media, this does happen. Of course, in every single country, the media will go down this route. They kind of seem to be plucking names out of a hat, thinking, yeah, maybe that one will work. Maybe that one will work. Maybe one of them will stick. But I just don't see right now Arthur, probably not even Dembele, departing this summer for Inter as part of that deal. But I could perhaps see Arturo Vidal because of that Conte link, because of that link there, clearly to Inter that he's already had, judging by previous wins. But with Lautaro, we will have to wait and see. Lautaro isn't the only forward, though, that has been linked to Barcelona over the past few days. Of course, with Sport opting to go down a different road, they've gone here with Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. And that's certainly the link that we've heard now, probably, for the last two, three, four transfer windows in a row, at least. And Sport say that Arsenal there have pretty much resigned themselves right now to losing Aubameyang in the coming summer, who's their top goal scorer of the season in the Premier League with 17 goals, which actually there puts him only second out of any player in the division, and the Gunners are extremely unlikely to secure Champions League football next season. Also, Aubameyang, his contract is running down, he will not sign a new one, and he could walk away for free in 2021 if they don't sell this summer, which, to be fair, is all very believable. I do believe that Aubameyang potentially will be leaving Arsenal this summer. But where this report here, linking him with Barcelona, very much falls down for me, is when we move on there to the reported transfer fee. Because Sport claimed there that Arsenal would still demand €55 million for Aubameyang this summer. And that, for me, that's absurd. That is absolutely ridiculous money there for Aubameyang. Because as good as he's been this season, as good as his goal record is, and it really, really is, I'm not doubting that. But right here, in July, we're going to be talking about a 31-year-old forward who's entering the final year of his contract. £55 million for that? I mean, really? And when you actually take a step back there and bear in mind that that figure is probably just slightly less than what Timo Werner is going to be going for this summer from RB Leipzig, well, that just makes it all look even worse. It's not a deal for me, not even a deal that we should be considering. And finally, guys, one more forward just to keep in the back of your mind right now would be Monaco's Wissam Ben Yedder, a name, of course, very familiar to us as Barcelona fans after his time in La Liga with Sevilla. And he's caused a bit of a stir in the media this week after he openly admitted that Barcelona had indeed inquired and approached him about a potential transfer. He actually came out and said very openly this week, "Barcelona contacted me last summer after they collected and scouted me on a number of occasions." He said an exactly the same approach happened in January too, but the move in the end, it didn't happen. And it's always very interesting, I feel, when players there openly come out and admit contact or openly discuss their interest of other clubs, because of course we've got no idea here whether Ben Yedder is telling the truth, and Barcelona are not going to come out to confirm or deny that. But either way, looking again at this kind of profile, again, he's a brilliant goalscorer. He's had a phenomenal season with Monaco in Liga 1 this season, but he's another player that come the summer is going to be turning 30, and you'd also imagine there that Monaco are going to be charging a big fee to let him go. And it's another kind of situation where you look at the market, you look at the players that are out there, and you just think, we don't really need to be going down that road. It's not the best of options. So that there, guys, is a bit of a news update to bring you right up to speed with everything that is going on with Barcelona right now. A bit of injury updates, a bit of transfer news, of course. Many, many players are going to be linked to Barcelona over the coming days, over the coming weeks. And right here, we're going to be breaking it all down and sorting it all out for you. Thank you, as always, for watching. Please do leave your thoughts in the comments down below. What do you think there of those Lautaro reports? Which players would you be open to exchanging with Inter Milan? Let me know. All of those thoughts in the comments down below. Plenty more still coming up on the channel. I will see you soon. Stay safe. But until next time, as always, Visca! El Barça!